to that.
I know. What? Very, very popular, Tim.
Very
now,
nice.
Opening night is tonight, right?
Yes. I've done 7 of these now. This is my 7th stage production. So, you know, the last one that people might remember was Ladies in Black. But it never gets easier. Opening nights are terrifying. And you're just sitting in there with your friends and you've got with Simon Phillips, our director, and, you know, you're just kind of, like, tight together, you know. And then if it goes well, which hopefully it will, it's the best buzz in the world and it's worth that terror, you know.
Is it scary not having any power? You've just got to sit in the crowd?
Yeah, weird. I would rather probably be backstage doing that than just
What's
sitting, pulling a rope.
Oh, right, OK. Just checking.
Being
using
one of
those guys. Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So what is it about this production, Come Rain or Come Shine, that made you want to get involved?
Well, I read the story. My wife, Marie, gave me the little book as a gift. It's a little short story by Katsuo Ishiguro, who's my favourite author, I would say. And it just sort of, I don't know, there were songs everywhere. Like, he'd even sort of kindly put some of them in capitals as if he was kind of suggesting a song title, you know, calling the characters by a certain name or whatever. And he is a songwriter himself, and so there's a lot of music in the story. It's about three friends who went to uni together, and then you jump forward 25 years, and one of them hasn't really done much at all, hasn't changed his life. The other two have. There's a triangle going on, a bit of unrequited love, a lot of broad farce. It gets very funny towards the end. Who knew Ishiguro was funny? But he is. You know, Remains of the Day is not a funny movie.
No,
but,
no.
Yeah, it's a great story. And we love these characters, so we'll see. Yeah.
You've kept busy during lockdown with something called the Forensics Project.
Yeah.
This is a fantastic idea. Can you just take us through it?
Well, Eddie Rayner, who was a keyboard player in Split Enz, and I decided to investigate early Split Enz music and find little segments that we'd always loved and then pull them out and sort of create an entirely new song using that. So the DNA of the early Split Enz song is in there, but it's a new song. And people are loving it. They love the fact that it reminds there's you know, memories and it's very evocative of the past, but it's also fresh and new. So, yeah, it was a writing project, just took off.
You're obviously very familiar with the original works. but when you pull them apart this way and sort of turn them into something new,
yeah.
Do you learn things about them that you didn't know when you'd written them?
I don't know about learn, but it's just, it's very emotional, kind of poignant, you know, because you're reminded of who you were then. Of course, you can't quite kind of grasp it because once you're, you know, a few decades past, it's gone, really. But... Mm. But you can sort of feel it, and there's an emotion there straight away. And you're not just playing with, it wasn't just me and Eddie, it was like, you know, there were 4 or 5 other guys there with us in a way. And it was really easy to write because I think the emotion was just so accessible.
Yeah.
I'm a massive fan of the classics. I still have a car that has a CD player in it, and I've got Split Enz and Crowded House CDs in my car. Do you get sick of people asking you to play the classics, or are you still rapt that people love them so much?
Of course, rapt, yeah. You know, it's amazing after so many years. And, you know, the thing is, when you're playing live, you just want it to go off. You want that feeling in the room, and whatever you've got that can make that feeling happen, where you and the audience become one, you're grateful to have that. You use it. You know, there's no... Oh, I need to play my new songs, or, you know, wish I didn't have to play this. I mean, I still love doing I See Red. I still love doing, you know, 6 months in a Leaky Boat. Mm. The crowd goes off and it's just a joyous feeling.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What about for you? What brings you that much joy? What do you think is the best work that you've ever done? Because it is an exhaustive discography that you've amassed.
I mean, I don't know about the best, but what I like is, you know, the one I wrote yesterday. I mean, it's that flow, that creative flow that still happens. And when it happens, it's very joyous. And that's, you know, what I'm mainly attracted to, I suppose. And then playing live, you can draw from the past, but when you're sitting at home and there's a piano or guitar or whatever, you just want to go into something new every time.
I think I heard Billy Joel once say, all my songs are my kids. but look at this new one, isn't it cute? Does that sort of sum up how you felt?
Yeah, it's always that new one that you're most excited by. You can't expect other people to be necessarily, but you are. Mm. And that's a joyous feeling.
So if you had to pick a favourite child, who is it?
I don't know. Somebody said the other day that I Hope I Never was their favourite song, so I'll go with that. You know,
just some bloke said that.
Yeah, he's a hairdresser. Yeah. Okay. Like, he was into electronic music, but he loves I Hope I Never, so God bless him.
But alternatively, what about the bratty kid? So what about when it's just not working? What do you do on those days?
You just, now I'm very good at just letting go. Like in the old days, I might have got a bit angsty. I haven't written a song for 2 weeks. Now it's like it could be 2 months, doesn't worry me in the slightest, you know?
Well, you've got a fair bit to fall back on.
Yeah, and it's, you know, go swimming, just stay in the moment. It's, you know, there's a lot of stuff to enjoy. We've got kids. I mean, I never thought I'd be a dad. I was 45 when our two children were born, or our first was born. I was nearly 50 when the second, our second child, our daughter, was born. And that's been an amazing gift in my life. And, you know, so...
But which one is your favourite?
Away with the metaphors. Now we want the actual favourite kid.
Hey, just before we go, I discovered today that you're my favourite Viking.
Really?
Yes.
I thought you don't know any others, do you?
Well, OK, all right.
Sam
you can I was trying to put it in a nicer way.
Fair enough.
How did you discover you're a Viking?
Because I got these kind of things in my palm, on this hand, these sort of hard... You know, kind of
swords.
Things.
No.
I don't know what they are, but there's a name for it. I've got apparently, and it's absolutely true. Apparently, yeah, I've got Nordic blood in me.
Hell yeah.
Mum was born in Ireland. She was a very Irish woman, and the Vikings were all through Ireland. You know, they were everywhere. Yeah. So, definitely, the DNA's merged and fused, and I've got a bit of it. So,
what's your hand thing?
I don't know what it is. It's got a name, but I don't know the name.
And apparently only Vikings have this.
Vikings deal in mystery, OK, Waleed?
I think they were doing a lot of that.
Ropes.
It's ropes. I'm not sure to call you if I should refer to you as Sir Viking or Lord Musician, but Tim Finn, thank you so much for joining us. And all the info for Come Rain or Come Shine with original music by the one, the only, Tim Finn, is available on our website. Tim, thank you so much for stopping by. Good luck for tonight.